Hello there, my YouTube friends and fans. I recently got access to GeForceNow, the beta actually, which is free. It will be costing, have a monthly fee in the future, but I thought I'm gonna make a little video because I really like this idea. It's basically where you can play your favorite PC games in the cloud at max settings with smooth frame rates, all powered by GeForce GTX GPUs in the cloud. So it actually allows you, for example, to play PC games if you have a Mac only, or it lets you play games that don't run on your maybe low quality PC machine or laptop at full settings and high speed and high quality, which is really super cool because a lot of people are in a situation that they just can't afford a really expensive PC, or they are on the Mac and they have maybe a super good Mac like I do that is very, very powerful, but they just don't make some of the games for the Mac, or actually a lot of games are not available for the Mac. And you can see here the library for GeForce Now is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And those games that you see in GeForce Now are actually optimized specifically for this program, but they say you can also play other games here as well. So I've tried PUBG and it ran really well. I just personally didn't like the game because I'm not a big fan of games where you have to camp a lot. I'm more like a runner and gunner. I also tried Dirty Bomb, for example, and that ran really well, and I really liked that game. And then I tried Subnautica, which actually you could see here runs really well on the Mac. You don't need GeForce Now for that, but I just wanted to test it. And actually that game didn't run as well on GeForce Now than actually directly on my Mac for some reason. So now the Call of Duty multiplayer is free this weekend, so I thought, hey, let me try to see how that runs, because I definitely don't want to buy that game. I don't like that Call of Duty at all. I used to be a big fan, no longer like it. I think once you become a Battlefield player, Call of Duty just feels like a kid's game, or kind of like a mobile version of a Battlefield game. Everything seems very small, tiny maps, and the graphics are just a little bit on the childish end in my opinion. So I personally I can't take this game serious, but I wanted to basically just test it. And the other thing that I just didn't like about this game, and I really wanted to kind of go in, you know, thinking, yeah, maybe I'm actually gonna like this since it's like boots on the ground again, but the characters, they are so wobbly. They run like they're like, you know, drunk or something, and I got super dizzy. I had to stop after about an hour because I just couldn't play any longer. I was so dizzy because when the character runs, he just kind of wobbles up and down, which makes it really, really hard to actually aim. And then the gun, for some reason, when you move it around, it always seems to be a couple of frames behind to where you point. It's just not what it looks like, but what it feels like. It just doesn't feel solid to me. And I had a really, really hard time to actually move around in this map and even to aim. And that's maybe just me because I haven't really played any multiplayer shooters at all on the Mac besides Counter-Strike, and that's been also a really long time ago. I usually just play single player survival games on my Mac, and that's absolutely no problem. But for some reason, playing shooters with a keyboard and a mouse doesn't come as natural. It just doesn't feel as natural to shoot a gun with a mouse than actually have a trigger, which I really like. You know, on the controllers, you have an actual trigger, and when you move the gun around, it also feels more natural, like how you would kind of hold a gun and shoot a gun. And so I think I will always have a problem getting used to shooting a gun with a mouse versus a controller. But you know, I have played like Dirty Bomb and Counter-Strike, and I don't have the same issues that I have in Call of Duty, where the characters are wobbly and where I get dizzy. I never get dizzy in Counter-Strike, and I have done really, really well in Counter-Strike, actually extremely well. So I don't know what it is. I've noticed that with the last, I think it was Black Ops 3 that I played the beta on. It was the same issue. I just couldn't ever get used to the wobbliness of the character, and it just somehow makes me dizzy, even though I don't suffer from motion sickness. And you may probably think, oh yeah, maybe that has to do with the GeForceNow. There's maybe a delay on the server or something like that. And that could very well be, but to be honest, I felt the same thing when I played the Black Ops 3 beta on the Xbox. The exactly same thing. And I was like, I can never play this game. I would not even want to spend $10 for a game like this. So it was fun trying this out on GeForce Now, and I can just say I can highly recommend, if you are interested in this, to sign up for GeForce Now. It's free right now because it's still in beta, and you have to actually, unfortunately, get onto a waiting list, but it only takes about 3 weeks to get in. Well, that's how long it took me to get in. And then have fun. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.